Hey Pluto, my child, what happened? Why are you crying?
Dad, this is unfair. After hundreds of years of me being known as your child, now they are saying that I'm not your child. How is that true?
Who said that?
You know it. Those weird humans.
My child, it is time for you to know the truth. Gather your moons and fasten your orbit. We need to go back billions of years and need to know a story. Don't skip a second of it. Listen to me carefully. Once upon a time, around 4.6 billion years ago, nobody existed in our family. Not even me. There was only the cloud of dust and gas, known as the Solar Nebula. Gravity collapsed everything in on itself as it began to spin, and then I was born at the center. Later, the remaining material began to clump up, resulting in the formation of various members of our family. And you, my child, were one of my earliest children.
Then why am I not treated as your child?
It all began in the 20th century. On the planet Earth, creatures called human beings started to look for you in space, and in 1930, they found you. The credit for your discovery goes to Clyde Tombaugh. Later, you were named Pluto by an 11-year-old girl, Venetia Burney. They considered you the ninth and the most distant child of our family, called the Solar System. They considered you as my child for decades and decades. But later, in 2006, a few scientists gathered at the International Astronomical Union in Paris and declared you weren't a planet anymore, and our family was left with only 8 children.
No, Dad, please don't say this.
My dear child, after 1992, astronomers on Earth discovered a lot of celestial bodies similar to you, and this confused them and forced them to rethink the definition of a planet. Now, according to the IAU, for a celestial body to be a planet, it needs to fulfill 3 essential criteria. First, the object should revolve around me.
That I do, Dad.
Second, the object should be spherical in shape.
I'm also spherical.
Wait. Thirdly, the area around its orbit should be clear and should not have any equivalent or a bigger celestial body in its path. And my child, you do not fulfill this criterion.
This is unfair.
You have your friend Sharon, always rotating with you, like the two of you are a double planet. Not just that, while rotating around me, you cross the orbit of Neptune for 20 years. No other planet does that. If you are a planet, then you should not cross other planets' orbits.
But then who am I? What is my existence? Do I even exist?
My precious child, don't feel bad and don't cry. You are still very much a part of the solar family. Just not as a planet, but as a dwarf planet.
Really?
Yeah, you are a dwarf planet. My dear child, you have an amazing and mysterious world of mountains, valleys, plains, and craters. You are my very small kid, only 1/6 the width of the Earth. You also live very, very far away from me. I know you have nitrogen, methane, and carbon monoxide, and you are a very, very chill person. You also have 5 moons, and you have a very good bonding with Sharon. Together, you two are called the double planet. And that's what makes you unique and important. Do you know, these humans are so smart. They even sent a spacecraft to see you.
Yeah, I have seen that. It was way back in 2015 when some strange object crossed over me.
Yeah, That was NASA's probe, Space Horizon. It captured tons of your pictures and studied various things about you.
But for what?
Who knows? Humans are weird. I'll tell you about New Horizon some other day. And also, my child, it doesn't matter what those tiny creatures on Earth think about you. You are my child and will forever remain my child.